Welcome back to the online biology classes for 8th second year. Myself Sukanya Roy, and today we are going to have our second lecture on the chapter Bioresources of Assam. In our previous lecture, we had discussed about the plant resources of Assam, where we had discussed about the three important types of plant resources which are found in Assam. They were the timber yielding plants of Assam, the medicinal plants, and the fiber yielding plants of Assam. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about another type of bioresource of Assam, which is termed as the sericogenic resources of Assam. Okay, so these are those bioresources found in Assam where or which are actually involved in the production of silk. So here in this lecture, we will basically deal about the different types of sericogenic insects. Okay, so these are those insects which help in the production of different types of silk. This type of insects are also termed as silkworms, and they belong to the sericogenic resources of Assam. Okay. Now, what is the definition of the sericogenic insects? These insects are those which help in the production of silk, okay, which in turn is of very much economical value, or which have very much economical importance, okay, and is very famous worldwide. That means, in short, the insects which are involved in the production of silk are termed as sericogenic or sericigenous insects. Clear? Now let us have a look at their systematic classification, that is their taxonomic hierarchy. So here you can see that they belong to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda. Their class is Insecta. Okay, that is all of them are insects, right? So they belong to the class Insecta, and the order is Lepidoptera. That means all the sericogenic insects or the silkworms comes under the order Lepidoptera. Is it clear to all of you? Okay. Now the next topic is, what do you understand by the term sericulture? The term sericulture is defined as a process of rearing of silkworms and extraction of silk from them. That is the process of the culture of the different types of silkworms and extraction or production of silk out of them together is termed as sericulture. It is a very important agro-based industry of Northeast India. Okay, and the silk, the different types of silk produced by the silk moths of Assam are actually very much famous worldwide. Clear? So here are two images. You can see that in the first image here, it is shown that the different types of silk worms are being reared. Okay, and here you can see that they are utilized to extract silk threads from them, out of which the different types of fabric are produced. Okay, so the entire process of the cultivation and rearing of the silkworms and the production of silk from them is together termed as sericulture. Clear? So in this slide, we are going to discuss about the different stages, okay, under the process of sericulture. Basically, the process of sericulture involves four basic stages. The first one is host plant cultivation. Second one is silkworm rearing. The third step is rilling. And the fourth step is weaving. Now let us have a look at what are all these points. So the first one, that is the host plant cultivation. Here what happens in this step, the different types of plants, host plants, on which the silkworms actually feed upon this plants are actually grown and cultivated. Okay, so the process of the plantation and cultivation of the plants on which the silkworms actually feed upon is termed as host plant cultivation. That is, the silkworms, in order to produce silk, obviously they have to be reared very well and they have to be fed up upon very well. Okay, so different types of silkworms feeds on different types of plants. Okay, so based on that, the different types of silkworms are actually found in Assam, and the in order to perform the process of sericulture, it is very important to grow and plant the different types of host plants for feeding the silkworms. Clear? Thus, the host plant cultivation means the plantation and cultivation of the plants on which the silkworms feed. Clear? The next one is silkworm rearing. This step involves the culturing of the silkworms. Here, the silkworms are reared and cultured properly and protected from any type of diseases. The next step is reeling. It is a process of unwinding of the silk filaments from the cocoon. So what is cocoon? It is nothing but a silky encasement or a sack-like structure or a case which is spun or made by the larva of the silk moths. Okay, and like just to protect them from any type of external injuries. Okay, and within the cocoon actually they grow and develop, and ultimately they comes out of the cocoon as the adult silk moths. Clear? Now, what is reeling? It is nothing but a process of unwinding of the different silk filaments from the cocoon. So what happens actually, after the silk moths comes out as adults from the cocoon, these cocoons are washed properly and processed, and different silk filaments are extracted from them by a process termed as reeling. Understood? Next step is termed as weaving, which is the process of producing fabric materials from any type of fiber. Here, the production of silk from the silk filaments prepared from the cocoon made by the silkworms is termed as weaving. That is, the formation of silk from the silk filaments is termed as weaving. Clear? So these are the four steps of the means to perform the process of sericulture. Clear? Next is the classification of the silkworm. So based on the type of host plants and the quality of the silk produced by them, the silk moths can be divided broadly into two groups. The first one is mulberry silkworms and the second one is non-mulberry silkworms. From the name itself, it is evident that the silkworms which feeds on the mulberry plants are termed as mulberry silkworms, while the silkworms which doesn't feed on the mulberry plants are termed as the non-mulberry silkworms. Let us just have a look at what are the mulberry silkworms. So the larva of this moths, that is the mulberry silkworms, mainly feed on the leaves of the mulberry plants, and the silk produced by them is termed as mulberry silk, or it is locally termed as pat. Okay, so this mulberry silk is whitish or a bit yellowish in color. That means what? Mulberry silkworms are those silkworms which feed mainly on the leaves of the mulberry plants, and the silk produced by them is termed as mulberry silk. Clear? So the main important species which comes under the mulberry silkworms is termed as Bombyx mori, and it comes under the family Bombycidae. Do remember these terms. Clear? The next one is the non-mulberry silkworms. So all the other silkworms or the silk-producing moths which don't feed on the leaves of mulberry plants are termed as the non-mulberry silkworms. That is, in this case, the silkworms feed on the leaves of some other plants and they produce some other types of silk. Okay, it is not the mulberry silk. So they are termed as non-mulberry silkworms. So the important silkworms and which comes under the non-mulberry silkworms can be divided into three types again: Muga silkworm, Eri silkworm, and Tusher silkworm. So the scientific name of the Muga silkworm is Antheria asama or Antheria asamensis. Okay. The scientific name of the Eri silkworm is Philosemia ricini, and the Tusher silkworm is termed scientifically as Antheria myelita. Now, the type of silk which is produced by Muga silkworm is termed as Muga silk, and it is one of the most costly type of silk available, and it is a very famous type of silk which is used by the people all over the world. Clear? Next, the type of silk which is produced by the Eri silkworm is termed as Eri silk, and the type of silk produced by Tusher silkworm is termed as the Tusher silk. Clear? Now let us study about the Muga silkworms. So the type of silkworms which produces Muga silk are termed as the Muga silkworms, and the scientific name already we have seen that Antheria asama, or they are also termed as Antheria asamensis. Clear? Now, as I have said that the Muga silk is very much expensive, okay, and its quality is also very means like it has a very high quality of silk. So commercially, the Muga silk is termed as the queen of silk. That is, in among all the other types of silks silks produced, the Muga silk is very superior quality, and it's very much costly as well, and so it is commercially termed as the queen of silk. Remember this. Clear? So here's a picture of the larval stage of the Muga silkworms. Okay, let us now have a look at the systematic classification of the Muga silkworms. So the Muga silkworms belong to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Saturnidae, genus Antheria, and species Asamensis. Okay. Next, we will study about the different host plants of the Muga silkworm. So, the host plants means those plants whose leaves are actually fed to the silkworms in order for their proper growth and development. Okay, so in case of the Muga silkworm, the primary host plants or the most important host plants are the soam tree and the swallow tree. Clear? So the Muga silkworms do show a proper growth and development and proper production of very high quality of Muga silk when they are fed upon the leaves of the plants soam and swallow, and so they are termed as the primary and the most important host plants of the Muga silkworm. Next are the secondary host plants named as Mejankari, Bajramani, Digloti, etc. So this secondary host plants means in case if the soam and swallow plants are not available, then the Muga silkworm can also feed on the Mejankari, Bajramani, Digloti, etc. plants, but their growth and development will be better in case they are exposed to the soam and swallow. So try to remember this. These are often asked questions in the final exams. Now let us deal with the Aedes silkworms. So the scientific names of the Aedes silkworms already we have studied. They are termed as Phylosemia ricini, and the Aedes silk moths produce threads of Aedes silk. Okay, so the silk which is formed by the Aedes silkworms are termed as the Aedes silk. Clear? So here are the pictures of the Aedes silkworms. So you can see the larval stages are represented here, the different sizes of the worms. Okay, because they keep on changing their size through molting, and as a result, like they are actually undergoing the growth process here in the larval stage. So we will study about all of this in the life history in the next classes. Okay. Now let us deal with the systematic classification of the Aedes silk moths. So the Aedes silk moths belong to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Saturninidae. Up till here, the systematic classification of the Aedes silk moth is exactly same to that of the Muga silk moths. Clear? And genus of the Aedes silk moths are Phylosemia. Sometimes it is also termed as Semia, and species is Ricin. Clear? Next, we'll deal with the host plants of the Aedes silkworm. So, mainly the host plants of Aedes silkworm can be divided into two types: primary host plant and secondary host plants. So the primary or the main host plants for the Aedes silkworms are the castor plants. So if the Aedes silkworms are fed with the leaves of the castor plants, then their growth and development is very good, and they produce a very high quality of Aedes silk threads. Clear? While in case if the castor plant is not available, then they can also feed upon the leaves of Kesedu, Tapioca, Gomari, that is Gamhar plant, and so these plants are termed as the secondary host plants of the Aedes silkworm. So please do remember these names. These are asked in your finals exams. Okay. So that's all for today's class. We will be continuing with this chapter in the next lecture. Till then, stay tuned, study well, and thanks a lot everyone for listening to my class.